Hey financial devs, I hope you guys are having a great day. Today we're going to be doing a quick little video taking a look at how you can actually go ahead and open up a bank account as a teenager. So this is going to be for anyone under the age of 18, how to actually go ahead and open up what's called a checking account. I know when you go ahead and start off to try and get a job, you know, start making money, you know, before you even do all of that, you actually need a place, you know, where you can go ahead and actually store your money. You know, you can't just keep all of your money in like under your pillow or in an envelope, right? You want to actually have a place where you can go ahead and actually save your money. So we're going to be discussing how you can go ahead and actually open up a checking account. And again, this is going to be mainly for people between the ages of 13 to 18, ideally those who are underage, but technically the rules will also apply for people over the age of 18. They just wouldn't need as much of these different requirements. So we're gonna go ahead and break down the five different things you're actually gonna need to bring with you when you go ahead and open up your checking account. So first thing you're gonna actually need is a form of ID. So this is gonna be something such as your driver's license. This can also be perhaps like your passport, or maybe you have like an identification card, you know, something like that. You know, maybe you don't drive, and ID will do just fine, like ID card. Issued by the government, you know, state government. And you're also gonna need a second form of identification. So this would probably be your passport, an identification card of some sort. You can, I believe when I opened the account, I personally use like my student ID, because it has my name as well as a picture, like a picture of my face on the card. So, but I would actually say go ahead and call ahead and make sure you can go ahead and use that. Some places they might say, no, we want something a little more, you know, from the state or from like the government sort of ID, like a government issued ID. But usually if it's a second form of ID, they'll be more lenient with it. But with your main form of ID, you do want it to be like a government issued form of ID. Then from there, you're gonna actually wanna have some money saved, probably talk to your parent or guardian, because you're gonna actually have to go ahead and put in what's called an initial deposit. So it's just like an initial amount of money you have to go ahead and put into the bank account when you go ahead and do the paperwork to open up your actual checking account. Now with the initial fee, it is gonna depend on which institution you decide to go with, but for the most part, you're gonna expect to have to pay out anywhere from $25 to about $50. So I would recommend aiming for that amount. Now, if you need to go ahead and get real specifics for your specific institution, you've decided you wanna go with a specific one, I would actually go ahead and suggest checking out their website, and usually they'll have instructions on the requirements of what you need to open up a joint banking account as well. Then from there, you're gonna actually wanna save even more money to go ahead and pay what they call the service fee. Now you actually wanna go ahead and check out the website of whatever company you're gonna go ahead and use as, you know, your banking service. Usually on there, they're gonna go ahead and show you different ways that you can actually go ahead and waive that fee, waive your service fee for having an account with them if you meet one of those requirements. Usually if you're a student, they will usually actually go ahead and waive the fee for you, so you don't actually have to pay a service fee, but be prepared to pay a service fee if you don't meet one of the requirements. So I would definitely say, once you've decided, okay, you want to go ahead with a specific bank, to go ahead and check on their website and see, okay, what are the requirements I need in order to be waived for their service fee. But just keep in mind that banks do tend to charge a service fee if you don't meet one of those requirements. So try and meet one of those requirements. And last but not least, you're actually gonna go ahead and need to bring a parent or guardian with you. And they are gonna also have to go ahead and bring two different forms of ID as well. So the way this works is you're gonna be opening up what's called a joint bank account with your parent or legal guardian. And because they're over the age of 18, they're actually allowed to go ahead and open up an account, right? So when you go ahead and bring your parent with you, you're gonna actually create a joint account where both of your names are on that account. And again, because they are over 18, you are now technically allowed to open an account as long as it's with someone over the age of 18 that is your parent or guardian. And those are the five main requirements you're going to need to go ahead and open up a joint checking account. Now, specifics on the actual fees and payments are going to be dependent on what bank you decide to go with. You can go with big banks or you can go with credit unions. So take a look around, see maybe location is what you prefer, versus perhaps convenience over the phone sort of thing. So maybe you just want to find something that's really close to where you live, or you'd rather have the convenience of the mobile app. You know, those are different things to take into consideration as well. Now, no, usually when you go ahead and open up your checking account, you will have the option to go ahead and open up what's called your savings account. They're not the same thing, so be careful. If you go ahead and open up a checking account and that's all you want to open, that's fine. But you do usually get offered to go ahead and have a savings account open up with that checking account as well. So if you do remember that there are two separate accounts. One is your checking account where you go ahead and get like direct deposit money from your new job, whereas your savings account is where you go ahead and actually save your money. So you can't just use your saving account to go ahead and pay for things. You would necessarily pay for things more with your checking account or just in cash. So again, you can't just use your savings account to go ahead and pay for things. You gotta have to go ahead and transfer it over to your checking account. That's like a big difference between the two. I remember when I first had to open my very first checking account, I thought it was such a daunting task. And then when I finally opened it, I was like, oh, I'm finally an adult. I'm starting to adult here. So, you know, don't let it overwhelm you. It's just, you know, you just gotta really have those five different things that you need. You're gonna need your two forms of ID, you know, your service fee, your initial deposit, and then, you know, your parent. So, or legal guardian, right? Then from there, once you've opened up your account, you know, you should be ready to go ahead and do your direct deposits once you start making that money from your new job or from your current job, right? And you can start putting in those checks and making that moolah, and you know, life will be good. But just opening up a checking account might seem a little daunting because honestly, I think that's like the first step you really take into your, you know, own personal financial independence. But it's actually a lot simpler than you might think. Well, that wraps up our video today on how to go ahead and open up a checking account for people under the age of 18. And again, this will work for anyone between the ages of 13 to 18, but make sure to go ahead and look up the specific requirements at your institution's website. I really hope you guys enjoyed today's video, taking a look at how to open up a checking account if you're a minor under the age of 18. I really hope you guys have a really good day. Thanks for watching.